Manchester City go 4 points clear at the top of the Premier League as they smash Leeds United 7-0. Premier League players are being made to do their tests in their cars before they enter the training grounds. Arsenal sack Aubameyang as club captain, and the Gabonese striker is immediately linked with a move away from the club. Derby manager Wayne Rooney had his Land Rover vandalised after leaving it parked overnight at a Christmas market. Premier League clubs are looking into the legality of docking the wages of unvaccinated players if they're forced to miss matches and training sessions, as cases of players self-isolating in the top four leagues has skyrocketed this month. Spurs are open to offers for Dele Alli, and Newcastle United's Eddie Howe has made initial inquiries about the 25-year-old. Manchester United's Anthony Martial has been the subject of an exchange deal offer from Atletico Madrid. Fiorentina have set an asking price of £85 million for Serbian striker Dusan Vlahovic after the 21-year-old turned down their latest contract offer. And Barcelona maintain their interest in Erling Haaland is real, with Paul Pogba and Xavi Simmons also being discussed as potential signings. What's going on, people? Welcome back to another video. My name is Hugh Wizzy and you're watching Paper Talk. We are back again, bright and early on a Wednesday morning, to go through the latest breaking news for their desk and see exactly what's making the headlines in the back pages of these, the most fraudulent publications available to man. We buy them so that you don't have to. Love to your mothers. Hope you're doing well and looking after each other in these turbulent times. We're all we've got, people. For now, though, we have got four fraudulent publications to be going through, including The Guardian, The Daily Star, The Daily Mirror, and The Daily Mail. It's daily, like Thompson. It actually is. It's daily, like Paper Talk. Let's get down to business. Let's start on the back of The Daily Mail today, who have Magnificent Seven. Finally, a smile on Jack Grealish's face. Cracker Jack helped City destroy Leeds in what was their record-breaking Premier League defeat, a 7-0 thumping Manchester City, 3-0 up at half-time with goals from Phil Foden, Grealish and Kevin De Bruyne. And I tell you what, Kevin De Bruyne's second was an absolute thunderbolt from the gods. Pep Guardiola saying he really can do what he wants. The main story, get jabbed or it's a pay cut. Top clubs could dock the wages of unvaccinated stars. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. It all seems to be kicking off right now as Premier League and Football League clubs are considering, and when they say considering, they are exploring the legalities of docking the wages of unvaccinated players if they're forced to self-isolate and as a result miss training sessions or games themselves. I've got a feeling that Arsenal could be one of those clubs who are investigating, as Pierre-Emerick Aubameyang has been involved in a certain situation. Of course, last night, stripped of the Arsenal captaincy after returning home late from a trip to France last week. And sent home from the training ground on Thursday after Arteta explained that he had not followed the protocols. So, yeah, it's all kicking off, isn't it? Let me know your thoughts in the comments section below. Over here, a little word on Norwich losing to Aston Villa. Steven Gerrard's fine start as manager there continues. And Dean Smith really does look like he's in trouble already. Norwich City perhaps worse than I've seen them in a while. On the back of the Daily Mirror today, we have got Manchester City's Pep Guardiola and his bald, shiny head with clenched fists celebrating an absolute goal fest. A Kevin De Bruyne, a Kevin-inspired City go goal crazy at the Etihad, and Pep's superstars look unstoppable. Who is going to be able to stop them this season? They've only conceded 9 goals in 17 games, scoring 40 in the process, extending their lead at the top of the Premier League to 4 points, if only temporarily, with people's games in hand today. But sensational performance with Phil Foden, Kevin De Bruyne, Jack Grealish, Riyad Mahrez all looking absolutely top draw. Even John Stones and Nathan Ake getting on the score sheet. Over here, immediately as soon as he's been stripped of the Arsenal captaincy, what do you know, Pierre-Emerick Aubameyang could be a want-away star. Is the dressing room going to be completely lost now? Another huge name really being ostracised, and I get the feeling that potentially this could damage Arsenal's reputation when new players are thinking about joining the club, if this is how they are going to be publicly hung out to dry. But anyway, he's sort of done that to himself by returning home late from France last week, stripped of the Arsenal captaincy. Aubameyang is now being linked with a new home for sacked skipper Oba, and Barcelona reportedly getting involved in the conversation, interested in Aubameyang as a replacement for Sergio Aguero, who is of course unfortunately retiring due to his heart condition. But Mikel Arteta, when questioned about his disciplinary record, said is non-negotiables. And there is talk about the town that he may well have played his last game for the club. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. Don't forget, if you are new around here, please do subscribe to the channel. It helps out massively and we are growing day by day. Much love to the newest members of the Fraud Gang Members Club. You are massively appreciated. On the back of the Daily Star, we have, of course, Pep gets 7-up. Manchester City 7-0 win. Over and out. Is it actually over and out for Aubameyang, the axed Gunners skipper, now on Barcelona's wanted list? Here we have further confirmation that Barcelona are lining up Pierre-Emerick Aubameyang to replace Sergio Aguero. That is going to be my thumbnail. The £56 million man dropped from the weekend win over Southampton for returning late from France is now being linked with Barcelona as they are looking for a striker, because Manchester City legend Sergio Aguero, of course, who joined on a free transfer in the summer, is set to retire due to his heart condition. Over here we've got David Moyes fears a festive KO. Obviously the old is really causing a problem right now. He's basically saying that the relentless Christmas schedule is going to make players more vulnerable to the old over Christmas. The Premier League are actually going to step up testing following the cancellation of a couple of fixtures, including Brentford against Manchester United. There are some others being called into question as well. Brighton, Chelsea, Aston Villa, Leicester and Arsenal have all reported more positive cases than ever before, really. So it's not looking great. We're just praying that football doesn't get shut down. On the back... Fraudification Squad, love to your mothers, I see you. If you are new around here, please do join the Discord. The community is strong, links in the description box below. You can also follow me on all the appropriate social medias, with Twitter, we've got a bit of that. We do tweet occasionally. Instagram, I'm there very active these days, instagram.com/whoisy, or if you're trying to join the journey, Instagram.com/fraudulencia, my sons. On the back of the Guardian, we've got further confirmation that clubs are agreeing to beef up measures to avoid games being called off. Premier League clubs will introduce daily testing for players and training ground staff to avoid postponement of further games and, in a worst case scenario, a break in the competition altogether. Over here, of course, Jack Grealish, the £100 million man, happy as Larry. Magnificent seven from City floors ragged Leeds, who look an absolute mess. And down here we got further confirmation of the Arsenal news. Fallen idol Aubameyang in Arsenal exile and stripped of captaincy after Mikel Arteta said he failed to demonstrate the appropriate commitment and passion to play for the club. The striker, of course, named captain by Unai Emery in 2019, fastest Arsenal player ever to get 50 Premier League goals. He has fallen foul of the fans' favour and now is apparently being ostracised by Mikel Arteta for his disciplinary breach. Let me know your thoughts on this whole charade. It is going to be an epic Amazon all or nothing documentary, that's for sure, unless they edit this sort of thing out, but hopefully they're gonna leave all this in. That's about it for this time. If you've enjoyed the video, please do smash the hell out of the like button, subscribe to the channel if you are new, and turn those bell notifications on so you never miss an upload from your fraud father. We have got the West Ham game tonight, so please do stay tuned. I will be back and I'll see you on the flip side. Enjoy your day. For now though, I've been Hugh Izzy and this has been a lot of fun. Peace.